Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Colonel Fred L. Price, the class of 1975, chair of the Citadel Board of Visitors. Welcome to the inauguration of General Glenn M. Walters as the 20th president of the Citadel. Will Commander Joe R. Molina, chaplain to the South Carolina Corps of Cadets, please join me for the invocation. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem.
Let us pray. Almighty God, creator and sustainer of all, as we begin these proceedings, we invoke the power and presence of your spirit. As the torch of leadership is passed to General Walters, may this awesome responsibility be accompanied with an extra measure of your blessing, wisdom, and grace. For this is your appointed time for your faithful servant. May we be reminded and appreciate the responsibilities and opportunities for leadership General Walters will face, of the level of commitment and sacrifice he will exert in his duties, and of the love and unconditional support of Mrs. Walters that she will bring into his mission. May we use this occasion to commit our support to his tireless efforts and celebrate the ideals of honor, duty, and respect that he will embody in his administration. In your most holy name, we offer our prayer. Amen.
Please be seated. This is a momentous day in the history of our college, and it is a privilege, indeed a privilege, for me as chair of the Citadel Board of Visitors to preside over this installation ceremony. On behalf of the South Carolina Corps of Cadets, the students of the Citadel Graduate College, the faculty and staff, and the Citadel Board of Visitors, I extend a warm welcome. As I introduce the members of the platform party, I ask them to stand as I call their name. Please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. To my right, Lieutenant General Claudius E. Watts III, United States Air Force, retired, class of 1958, 17th President of the Citadel. Major General John S. Grinnells, United States Marine Corps, retired, 18th President of the Citadel. The Honorable Thomas Moldley, Undersecretary of the Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Jack J. Porter, Associate Professor of Political Science, Faculty Senate Chair. And to my left, Mrs. Gail Walters, First Lady of the Citadel. Colonel Julie Nethercott, United States Marine Corps, Military Assistant to the Assistant Commandant of the Marine Corps. The Honorable Henry Dargan McMaster, Governor of the great state of South Carolina. The Honorable John Tecklenburg, Mayor of the Holy City of Charleston. Brigadier General Mark Bebensee, Interim Provost and Dean of the College. Commander Joe Molina, Chaplain of the College. Colonel Leo Mercado, United States Marine Corps, retired, class of 1979, and President of the Citadel Alumni Association. Cadet Colonel Sarah Zorn, Regimental Commander of the South Carolina Corps of Cadets, member of the class of 2019. Mrs. Sherry Doney, the Citadel Graduate College, class of 2019. Mrs. Margaret Gannon, Administrative Assistant, Department of Mathematics, Staff Council Chair. Please join me in giving them a round of applause. It is now my pleasure to introduce my fellow members of the Citadel's Governing Board. I ask them to stand as I call their names, and please hold your applause until the end. Colonel Myron C. Harrington, Jr., United States Marine Corps, retired, class of 1960. Colonel Allison Dean Love, Citadel Graduate College, class of 1993. Colonel Dylan Goff, class of 2002. Colonel Peter McCoy, Sr., class of 1974. Colonel Gene Pinson, class of 1972. Colonel Greg LaPointe, class of 1985. Colonel Stanley Myers, Sr., class of 1998. Colonel J.C. Dominick, United States Air Force, retired, class of 1971. Colonel Jamie Kahn, class of 2000. Colonel James Nicholson, Jr., class of 1985. The Honorable Molly Spearman, State Superintendent of Education, ex officio board member. Major General Van McCarty, class of 1982. South Carolina National Guard, Adjutant General of the State of South Carolina. Colonel William Jenkinson III, class of 1968, Emeritus Member. Colonel Douglas Snyder, class of 1982, Emeritus Member. Please join me in giving them a round of applause. We are especially pleased that delegates representing higher education institutions from across the state and nation have joined us for this special occasion. We are also pleased to have as our guests several prominent national, state, and community leaders. And we are appreciative of our academic leadership of the Citadel. The deans, academic department heads, faculty senate, and all the talented Citadel faculty present today who are here in support of the president, as well as our dedicated staff from all campus areas. The Citadel is proud to be a part of Charleston, known as the Low Country of South Carolina, and of our great nation. And what we do here today is important for several special constituencies of the Citadel. Therefore, it is fitting that a representative from each constituency offer greetings on this significant occasion. From its beginning, by an act of the South Carolina General Assembly, the Citadel has served our state by educating and developing students to be principal leaders in all walks of life. We are presently a college of nearly 3,700 students, of which more than 2,300 are South Carolina Corps of Cadets, showcased here today. As a state institution of higher education, we welcome South Carolina's governor, who brings greetings on behalf of the citizens of South Carolina. Governor McMaster is a native of the state and a graduate of the University of South Carolina and the University of South Carolina School of Law. A tireless public servant, Governor McMaster is a recipient of the Order of the Palmetto, which is the highest civilian honor in this state. He served as Lieutenant Governor prior to his inauguration as South Carolina's 117th governor on January the 24th, 2017. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my honor to present to you the governor of the great state of South Carolina, Governor Henry McMaster.
Thank you, Colonel Price. It's a pleasure for Peggy and me to be in humble Charleston, South Carolina today with you, the greatest place on earth, of course, and where the humble Charlestonians say the Ashley and Cooper Rivers join together to form the Atlantic Ocean. This is a great place. I've got 3 minutes, so I'll try to make it count. It is a pleasure to see you. One of the greatest moments I had in recent years was at Corps Day a year or so ago to watch the cadets march in the dress whites. It was a thrill. And it occurred to me once again of the importance of this institution. It was on December 20th, 1842, that the magazine and Citadel in Charleston and the Arsenal in Columbia became military academies, later become the South Carolina Military Academy. You may know that the governor's mansion today was the officer's residence at that Arsenal Academy. The rest of the school was burned on February 17, 1865, as you will remember. On March the 20th, 1843, the first 20 young men assembled at Marion Square to mark the very first Corps Day, which has been continued until now. Thus began the great story of one of the most historic and distinguished institutions in United States history. I revel in it. The influence of this place and its traditions of duty, honor, respect, country, and discipline have set us in this state apart from other states and have contributed mightily to the success, prosperity, strength, and happiness of our people. And so, it is with great pride that I, on behalf of almost 5 million grateful South Carolinians, welcome General Glenn Walters and Mrs. Walters to the state of South Carolina and congratulate the Board of Visitors on their wisdom in offering the general this position and on the general in his good judgment in accepting it. And always and eternally, my congratulations, thanks, and respects to the Corps.
Thank you, Governor McMaster. We really appreciate you making the time to be with us here today. Thank you so much, sir. Our next speaker gives greetings on behalf of the city of Charleston. Mayor John Tecklenburg, a Charleston native, is a successful businessman who transitioned into a compassionate public servant. The partnership between the Citadel and the city of Charleston has been strong since our beginnings in 1842. Indeed, in 1922, the city provided the land along the banks of the Ashley River for the campus we enjoy today. It is my great pleasure to present the mayor of Charleston, the Honorable John Tecklenburg.
Thank you very much. That was a pretty nice piece of real estate we got y'all started off with. Thank you, Colonel Price, and I want to thank you and all the Board of Visitors for your remarkable leadership for this great institution. Distinguished guests and Citadel faculty and staff, assembled guests, the reason General and Mrs. Walters are here today, why we are all here today, is really for the members of the Corps of Cadets. The Citadel is a special place among colleges and universities because it teaches young adults lifelong leadership skills. Keeping brass polished and shoes shine, shirts tucked, rooms clean, rifles spotless, rooms tidy, and bodies fit are not normal requirements for a college. The ability to pay attention to these sorts of requirements, in addition to the various academic pursuits, is a true lesson of leadership and responsibility. And by the time they reach 22 years of age, most Citadel cadets have mastered these skills, among others. They've learned how to serve as leaders and bear the responsibility of young men and women under their command. And so, the president of this college must not only be an excellent administrator of an academic program and to do all the things that that entails, but he must also serve as a strong leader role model, someone that each cadet can learn the principles of leadership and seek to emulate at the Citadel and long thereafter. General Walters is that leader. He is a great role model and will instill the lifelong leadership traits in all members of the Corps of Cadets who are fortunate to study during his tenure. A graduate of the Citadel himself, he is imbued with the Citadel motto, as you are: honor, duty, respect. And then in an amazing career with the United States Marines, General Walters lived under that motto, Semper Fi, short for Semper Fidelis. The Latin, we say, means also always faithful. But in fact, the English word that derives from fidelis is fidelity. And its more full definition is faithfulness, faithfulness to a person, cause, or belief by continuing loyalty and support. That's the life that General Walters has lived. Now, I'm going to date myself a little bit. I know the Corps of Cadets is familiar with the term Wi-Fi. When I was your age, I was a little fascinated with the term hi-fi, high fidelity, which means, in this case, an accurate, an exact copy or reproduction. We were trying to find that good recording from the sound studio, right? Hi-fi. So I'm just going to leave you that, General Walters, you are the hi-fi of Semper Fi for the Citadel honor, duty, and respect. An example to this Corps of Cadets today and for the years to come. General and Mrs. Walters, congratulations, Godspeed, as you mentor these future leaders, and on behalf of the city of Charleston and the Charleston region, not welcome to Charleston, but welcome home, sir.
Thank you, Mayor Tecklenburg. There is a bond of fellowship and responsibility among Citadel graduates, which is reflected in an uncommon loyalty to this institution. I am pleased to introduce a classmate of General Walters, Colonel Leo Mercado, United States Marine Corps retired, class of 1979, and president of the Citadel Alumni Association, who brings special greetings from the alumni of the college. Colonel Mercado.
There's probably nothing that can put more apprehension in General Walters than to see one of his classmates take the microphone.
I trust you, Leo.
Yes, sir. As president of the Citadel Alumni Association, I have the distinct privilege to welcome General Walters on behalf of all Citadel alumni. Our alma mater is very fortunate to have one of our most distinguished graduates return home to serve and lead the Citadel's continued ascent as a preeminent institution for educating and developing principled leaders. As our president, we entrust you to safeguard our military heritage, our unique system of delivering a classic military education, and developing men and women of character who are instilled with a sense of honor and selfless service that makes our alma mater distinctive and appealing institution of higher education. With your leadership and our unwavering support, the legions of Citadel graduates stand ready to advance and promote the ideals and purposes of the Citadel, the Military College of South Carolina. We wish both you and Gail the very best and continued success for the Citadel and the Long Gray Line.
Thank you, Colonel Mercado. The Citadel is a distinctive institution because it not only has outstanding students, who are the young men and women comprising the South Carolina Corps of Cadets, but also those students who are enrolled in the Citadel Graduate College. We have a representative from each of our student bodies to give a welcome on behalf of all Citadel students. For the Corps of Cadets, I am pleased to present to you Cadet Colonel Sarah Zorn, the regimental commander. Cadet Colonel Zorn from Aiken, South Carolina, is earning a business administration degree and will commission into the United States Army as a field artillery officer upon graduation. She has many accomplishments, including Dean's List, President's and Commandant's List, and is the recipient of two of the Citadel's highest honors, the Palmetto Medal and the Society of Cincinnati Award. Cadet Colonel Zorn serves as the regimental commander of the South Carolina Corps of Cadets. Cadet Colonel Zorn.
Thank you, Colonel Price. On behalf of the Corps of Cadets and our active duty day students, I welcome you to this unique and honorable event. As a graduate of the Citadel Class of 1979, General Glenn Walters received his commission into the United States Marine Corps and dutifully served for 39 years, culminating his career as the Assistant Commandant of the Marine Corps. Now, General Walters has chosen to return to the Citadel as the president of our renowned institution. The Citadel maintains its profound history of excellence in academics, military discipline, and physical readiness. As the cornerstone of our institution, our dedication to producing leaders who are morally and ethically sound. We are in awe of the magnitude of General Walters' remarkable career, and we are grateful for his commitment to the Citadel and our core values of honor, duty, and respect. General Walters and our lovely First Lady Gail Walters have brought their ideas and tremendous energy to the campus. The Corps of Cadets is proud to have them both on our team, a team that will continue to propel our institution into the future and produce leaders our nation needs today. General and Mrs. Walters, on behalf of the South Carolina Corps of Cadets, I would like to thank you for your daily leadership and inspiration. It has been an honor to work with both of you this year. The Corps is excited to see where your leadership will take us. Thank you for your fortitude to stand for our mission to produce principled leaders in all walks of life. It is a pleasure and honor to represent the Corps of Cadets at your inauguration, knowing we are all grateful for your commitment to be the Citadel President. Thank you.
Thank you, Cadet Zorn. I am pleased to introduce Ms. Cherie Doney, a Navy veteran trained as a nuclear-powered electrician for the world's greatest nuclear-powered fleet. She is a nursing student within the inaugural class that is set to graduate from the Citadel Graduate College in May. Ms. Doney is a recipient of the Baker Veterans Fellowship Award, the Outstanding Veteran Student Award by the Citadel's Academy of Science and Mathematics, and the Academic Excellence in Leadership Award by the Office of Military and Veteran Affairs. Ms. Doney.
Thank you, Colonel Price. General Walters, it's wonderful to see you. I am honored to represent the 1,300 graduate college students in celebrating your inauguration today. The Graduate College is comprised of graduate, evening undergraduate, veteran, and online students from around the world. Since 1968, Graduate College students have chosen to pursue their education at the Citadel for similar reasons of that of the cadets. We desire a challenging education with small class sizes, led by faculty and staff who genuinely care about our educational success and personal growth. Here, we build relationships with our peers during our evening classes, becoming more than colleagues, becoming family. Many, like myself, are furthering our education while juggling the demands of families and jobs. So we appreciate the Citadel's commitment to our continued success and their incorporation of the core values, honor, duty, and respect, into each and every day and aspect of our Citadel experience. General Walters, the graduate body, admire your long and accomplished military career. We are eager to see the progression of your administration as you build on the strength of the Graduate College. Those of us comprising of it, we are grateful to be a part of the Citadel family, and we wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Doney. We recognize that all colleges and universities are ultimately measured by the strength and vitality of their faculty and staff. At the Citadel, we are proud of the excellence of our faculty and staff members who are committed to our mission. It is my pleasure to present the chair of the Faculty Senate, Dr. Jack Porter, Associate Professor of Political Science. Dr. Porter will convey the greetings from the faculty. Dr. Porter.
Thank you, Colonel Price. General Walters, it is my profound honor to represent the faculty in officially welcoming you to the Citadel. As scholars and educators, we admire your encompassing spirit and your laudable and highly acclaimed service to our nation. We are inspired and energized by your vitality and your passion for your alma mater and your heartfelt commitment and dedication to making the Citadel an even more distinguished institution. We, like you, are passionate about our mission to educate and develop principled leaders. Each of us was drawn to this college for precisely that reason. And because we are a community, in all the best senses of that ideal, where genuine learning is the focus and where scholarly inquiry can be pursued by both students and professors. We, the faculty, commit our full support to you. We are enthusiastic and eager colleagues, and we look forward to working tirelessly with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Porter. And now I present the Chair of Staff Council, Mrs. Margaret Gannon, who will convey greetings from the Citadel staff. Ms. Gannon?
Good afternoon. General Walters, it is my honor and pleasure to welcome you to the Citadel from the staff. We are excited to join you in working to keep the Citadel a premier academic institution and a great place to work. We promise to support you as you fulfill your vision for the college, and we stand ready to serve you and your administration. So as it's been said before, and on behalf of my colleagues, the men and women who comprise the Citadel staff, I am delighted to bid you and Mrs. Walters, welcome home.
And thank you, Mrs. Gannon. The investiture of a president is a significant event in the life and welfare of every college. Since the Citadel is a public institution with a commitment to public service, it is most appropriate that our inaugural speaker, Colonel Julie Nethercott, United States Marine Corps, is a public servant whose career is a model of service to others. Colonel Nethercott was commissioned in May 1993 following her graduation from Midland University. Rising in command, she deployed in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom and twice in support of Operation Enduring Freedom in Africa and Afghanistan. After assuming command of Officers Candidate School in Quantico, Virginia, she was selected to serve in her current position as the military assistant to the Assistant Commandant of the Marine Corps, where she supported General Walters until his retirement. It is my great pleasure to present to you a highly decorated Marine officer and personal friend of the Walters, Colonel Nethercott.
Well, thank you, Colonel Price, for that kind introduction. And good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. It is truly my honor and privilege to be with you today as we celebrate the inauguration of your 20th president. To Governor McMaster, Secretary Moldley, General Walters and Gale, to the Board of Visitors, the esteemed faculty and staff, the Corps of Cadets, the grad students and the veterans in the audience, thank you for allowing me to join you today. I just want to take a few moments this afternoon to provide some insight about your new president, General Walters. Don't be worried, sir. I was given guidance. I had the honor as serving as his military assistant when he was the 34th Assistant Commandant of the Marine Corps. And when you serve with a leader in that capacity, you get to know them very, very, very well. And you also learn a lot. Of the countless lessons that I learned from General Walters, there are three that I would like to share with you this afternoon as you begin your journey with him as your next president. The first lesson that I learned from General Walters was, regardless how good you are or how good your unit is, you must always be willing to grow. While honoring and recognizing the history of your unit or your institution, you cannot rest on your laurels, but you must continually improve to get even better and take it to the next level. Two examples really drive this point home. As some of you may know, General Walters was a test pilot, and he was instrumental to the success in the fielding of the MV-22 tilt rotor aircraft, otherwise known as the Osprey. His willingness to both find gains on the margins and to be a bold innovator took Marine Corps aviation to an entirely new level, and this was based on his strategic vision. The second example that showcased his capability of taking an institution to another level were his efforts regarding talent management in the Marine Corps. While the Marine Corps' reputation for recruiting excellent men and women is well earned, he knew we could still do even a little bit better. He established the Talent Management Executive Council with the understanding that the strengths of a great team, a great unit, or a great institution, in our case, the Marine Corps, was about utilizing the diverse talents of all of our members and leveraging their different perspectives and skills. Due to his efforts, the Marine Corps continues on an upward trajectory in recruiting, promoting, and retaining the best talent that we can find. And I have no doubt that he will bring that same strategic mindset to the Citadel. The second lesson that I learned from General Walters was that you should always strive to meet or exceed the standard. And I had the opportunity to observe General Walters speak to many audiences in all of our travels. And whenever he had provided advice to a group of leaders or commanders, he always had a couple of points. He would advise the new commanders and leaders to get that published checklist for their command and to study it, because that is the standard that they would be held to as a leader and a commander. And for the Corps of Cadets in the stands, his point was simple. You know what is expected of you going in, so work hard, be disciplined, don't overthink it, practice your tradecraft and the basics, and you will rise to the standard. These points were no doubt steeped in the traditions of his alma mater, to lead a life of service, accepting the challenge, and demonstrating resilience at every opportunity. When he would speak, he was also reminding the audience that if you guide and lead your team to accomplish the standard, then the mission and you will be successful. And all of this hinges upon how you take care of your people, your team, and your unit. And if you understand them and build that camaraderie, you will no doubt enjoy success. Which would bring him to his next point and my third and final lesson. The third lesson that I gained from my time with General Walters is that it is completely all about the people. Whether you're in the Marine Corps or you're here at the Citadel, it is about the people that you meet and you serve. One of the things that he would always remind audiences and he would offer to them was, as a leader, you should find someone who does not look like you, does not think like you, and have a conversation. I realize that this may seem like a lost art in the world of Twitter, texting, and Snapchat, but he was and is absolutely correct. Taking the time to have that simple conversation over a cup of coffee or a beer, your choice, with someone who is different than you makes us better leaders, makes us better people, and definitely advances our units and our institutions. And it gives you a unique perspective that enables to take your team to greater heights. General Walters truly understands this third point, and thus you will not find a more sincere, thoughtful, and selfless leader to be your 20th president. I have no doubt that General Walters will take the institution of the Citadel with its 176 years of tradition and history to even greater heights. He will encourage the students to uphold the honor and the traditions by meeting the standard, while encouraging them to be even better leaders. He will endeavor the Citadel to grow and become even better, finding those seemingly small gains on the margins and through his strategic vision. In closing, I truly believe that great leaders come to organizations at the exact right place and right time in their history, and I have no doubt that this is the case for General Walters and Gale. The Citadel has a bright future ahead of it, and I look forward to seeing what is achieved by this college and its Corps of Cadets in the years to come. Thank you again for having me today, and you are blessed with an amazing leader in General Walters, and I wish you all the best. Semper Fidelis.
Thank you, Colonel Nethercott, for those thoughtful and inspiring remarks. On behalf of the college, I express our sincere appreciation for your presence here today and for your support of the Citadel and our new president. It would be difficult for us to imagine a person better suited to become the 20th president of the Citadel than General Glenn M. Walters. In the literature of the college, we have often relied on a phrase by John Milton to describe the complete education we provide our students. We want there to be a totality to the Citadel experience, an experience that develops the whole person so that those who graduate are prepared for every opportunity and responsibility in life. John Milton said, "I call for a complete and generous education, that which fits a graduate to perform justly, skillfully, and magnanimously in all offices, both public and private, in peace and war." General Glenn Walters surely fits Milton's description. General Walters brings an extraordinary combination of quality and talents to the president's office, qualities that will enable him to leave the Citadel forward. Consider these measures in our new president. General Walters is a leader. He has distinguished himself throughout his outstanding career in the United States Marine Corps. General Walters understands firsthand the strengths and the challenges that we face at the Citadel. He appreciates the essential values and limitless potential for a life well lived that a Citadel education provides. It is understandable how the Presidential Search Committee and the Board of Visitors were inevitably drawn to General Walters. He is an alumnus who believes in the traditions of the Citadel. He shares the same high aspirations for our college with all alumni, and he is deeply committed to the time-honored values that this institution has always held dear. This now brings us to the important task at hand, the investiture. General Walters, will you please join me, and I ask the Board of Visitors Vice Chair, Colonel Myron Harrington, to assist me. By the authority vested in me by the General Assembly of South Carolina, and with the approval of the Board of Visitors, I hereby formally invest you with the duties and responsibilities of the President of the Citadel, as prescribed by the college regulations. This medallion of the college that you are wearing symbolizes the authority and responsibility that is now yours. With that authority imposed on you is the obligation to maintain high academic standards and unique traditions of the Citadel, and to assure preeminence among institutions of higher education. The Board of Visitors entrust you with this responsibility, knowing that you will justly and skillfully discharge your duties and fulfill your responsibilities in the most commendable manner. We look forward to many years of service as president of our college. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It just dawned on me before I start my remarks that I'll be the worst speaker you hear today. But there's a bright spot in my life, because I can look over this half of the Corps of Cadets and I can see daylight on the front of the field house. Sorry, I think you're marching today. Thank you, Colonel Price. Thank you and to all the speakers for your kind and encouraging words. I'm not going to ad lib. Thank you, Leo, for keeping it clean. I appreciate everybody attending here today at this ceremony. Your presence speaks volumes about how much you care about the continued success of the Citadel. And I'm getting this up front right now because I haven't done it for the last four times in a row. And on a personal note, I want to thank my wife, Gail, for her love and support these past 24 years. Thank you for embracing this incredible new chapter in our lives. And if she has a glass of wine in her hand, she will tell you that, yes, I did forget the last four or five ceremonies. She'll give you the accurate number. Thank you, honey. I love you. It's very humbling. Hey. It'll be you someday. It's very humbling to return to my beloved alma mater to lead this incredible institution as its 20th president. It's a dream come true to return to a place that I consider home. We are grateful for everyone for your warm welcome and all of your best wishes. I'm especially pleased to thank my predecessors here on stage with me, General Watts and General Grinnells. General Rose was supposed to be here, but he's where he's supposed to be, tending to his father in Florida right now. Each of you has led this college through challenges while preserving our identity, the Military College of South Carolina since 1842. And I would be remiss if I did not thank Colonel Price and the Board of Visitors for their confidence in selecting me for this privilege of following in your footsteps. I'd also like to welcome Secretary Moodley. He lives and works in Washington, D.C. He's here because he'd really rather live in Charleston. As I prepared for this great day, I thought about my first day as a cadet. Don't laugh. In 1975. I rode down from Virginia with my good buddy Robert Creedon, driven by his father, Sergeant Major Robert Creedon, United States Marine Corps. We had met while we were both stationed together. Our dads were stationed together in New Delhi, India. After a long drive from Virginia, I expected a few inspiring words from this Sergeant Major, and he delivered. He gave me a great call to action as we approached 1st Battalion. As I recall, he said, "This is your stop. Get out." Back then, I could not imagine or begin to imagine what this place would mean to me. I had professors who taught, inspired me to earn my electrical engineering degree here. I endured a Spartan, challenging environment that taught me I could rely on the people around me to overcome every challenge. Those people whom I encountered in the barracks, on the lacrosse field, in junior sword drill, in my Marine training, in the classroom, and in a select number of local establishments where a thirsty cadet could find refreshment. These people I will always treasure forever, because they started me down a path and my experience was opened here. My experience here taught me about service, challenge, resilience, and camaraderie in a way that I don't believe any other institution could do. My experience here was not unique to me. These common elements are the essence of what everybody that comes here experiences and what this college is about. Service, challenge, resilience, camaraderie, some of the finest traditions of the Citadel, the reason we all love the Citadel and this place and the people who are part of what we are here today. As I prepared, I also thought about some of our other traditions, like our alma mater. We sing the first stanza at many of our college events. The second stanza, we seldom sing publicly. It ends with the words, "Our mighty citadel." These words have a special meaning because they make us think about what's special about our college. And they make us think about the task at hand and what we can do to preserve what is special about this college, while also taking the steps necessary to make sure that this college and what it stands for will stand forever. We are a mighty citadel with a sacred mission to educate and develop principal leaders for all walks of life. The values-based education we offer here is more important now than it ever has been. To stand forever, we must preserve the traditions that make the Citadel such a special place, the traditions of service, challenge, resilience, and camaraderie. Like we always have, we will continue to evolve so that we can offer this experience in a context that applies today and in the future. To the Corps of Cadets, you are having an experience now that you will never forget. I'm not talking about my speech. You will leave these gates transformed by your service to others on campus and in our communities, by the challenges you overcome, and by the close bonds you have made with your classmates. By coming here and aspiring to make yourself a better person, a principal leader, you have been prepared to succeed in your life's work, be that in the military, business, education, or leaders of our communities, state, and great nation. Like all of us who wear the ring, we stand for our core values of honor, duty, and respect, the ideals of the Citadel. When we live by these core values, we create a perfect proving ground where anyone who comes here will be welcomed, challenged, and ultimately transformed for the better. I am thrilled to see these values continue to have a prominent place in our campus life and can assure you those ideals will be faithfully preserved. To our faculty and staff who serve here, we must make sure that you have the resources you need to fully serve your mission. The Citadel Foundation, our foundation, has helped our passionate alumni and friends make our luck in partnership with our great state of South Carolina. Because of this support from our larger Citadel family, our college remains the number one public college in the South, as we have been for 8 consecutive years. To achieve this feat, many in our community have been conspicuously generous with their time, talent, and treasure. Thank you for all you do, and you will continue to do. Our future is bright. In addition to maintaining our outstanding academic programs and leadership training, we're in the process of transforming our campus to enable the most state-of-the-art teaching methods while modernizing some of our ancient buildings and infrastructure. As you came on campus today, you may have noticed construction beginning for our new academic building in decades, the first one in decades, the new Basson Hall to house our Tommy and Victoria Baker School of Business. It will be a cutting-edge facility built entirely by the generosity of loyal donors. Next will be the replacement for our largest academic building, Capers Hall, which houses the Zucker Family School of Education. This building is also where many of our core courses are taught. It has been a long time coming, but together we will see it through. We have learned that when we develop a comprehensive strategic plan, we can harness the energy of our entire Citadel family. The plan is being finalized and will include other projects and programs to advance our mighty Citadel. Governor McMaster, on behalf of the Corps of Cadets, our students, our faculty, our staff, our alumni and friends, I want to thank you for your generous support to our institution. We are proud of our unique role and the service that our Citadel family offers South Carolina and the Lowcountry every day. Working together, we will preserve, protect, and advance our great college. We should all be proud to carry on the mission of producing principal leaders and to further expand the college's commitment to service, learning in our community, state, and nation. It's an exciting time to be part of our great Citadel family, this state, and this country. Let's get to work. One more thing. Quiet. Since today brings a new chapter in the Citadel's life, by the authority vested in me as the president of Citadel, I hereby declare all cadets who are eligible to get weekend leave. I can take it back. And in consultation with the governor of the great state of South Carolina, I also grant amnesty to all who get your eligible.
General, what a great way to start your administration. I know you got about 2,400 fans out there immediately, you know, so, and I'm sure they won't mind going to parade now. So, come on. This is a great day to be part of the Citadel. As we bring this ceremony to a close, I express once again my sincere appreciation for your attendance at this historic occasion. We invite you to join us as we continue the celebration with a full dress parade by the Corps of Cadets beginning at 4 o'clock. Please stand and join in singing the Citadel Alma Mater, which is printed on the back cover of today's program. And if you would please remain standing as our new president, platform guests, delegates, and the faculty recess. And with their departure from the auditorium, the formal inauguration of the 20th president of the Citadel comes to a close.
Thank you.